the sun. To dream, believe in strength. Now I'm the only one, only one. I was an ordinary boy until I broke the rules. My life destroyed.
How are you today? The improved package has arrived. We're having it fitted in time for FP1. Have a look at the factory report.
Race fans, the clock is ticking down to the start of today's practice session here at the Marina Bay Street Circuit, the setting for this weekend's Singapore Grand Prix. I'm here with Anthony Davidson once again. Nice to see you, Ant, and I wanted to ask you about how you go about improving the car over the course of a practice session. How much would you say is already known from the pre-race simulations? And how much do you have to do, you know, how much do you have to work on with a real car on a real circuit?
Well, that's a good question, Crofty, and I suppose the simple answer is that there's no such thing as too much information. As you say, the bigger teams have very complex simulations, vast numbers of clever people crunching the numbers back at base. But what they can't tell you is stuff like how the track condition's going to be, or what the temperature's going to be doing over the course of the day, and how all of that's going to be interacting with the tyre. There are so many millions of tiny variables involved in getting these cars around a racetrack quickly, but the computer can't tailor the car to a driver's specific balance requirements. At some point, you still need to put a human being in there and have them feel it through the seat of their pants. And that's why we end up with different drivers having different setups. So what I'm trying to say is, Crofty, nothing beats on-track testing.
We're going to be logging some extra data during this session. Nothing you need to worry about, but as we have some new parts, we'll just confirm they're performing to spec.
This lap.
Right, Chris. Chris probably mentioned the new parts that have come in from the factory. Well, they're all fitted and good to go. I hope they do the trick. Okie dokie, we'd like to get a tyre wear program done on at least one compound during these sessions. We can get some good strategy and development information, so it's worth the effort.
As all the cars are now over the line, your top three again are Hamilton, Verstappen, and Nico Rosberg. Thank you for joining us for free practice today. We'll be back with more Formula One action very shortly. Classification at the end of the session then. Here are your top three: Rosberg, Hamilton, and Kimi Raikkonen. That's it for practice then. We'll see you again soon.
Passing on your qualifying goals for this weekend.
It's late in the evening here in Singapore and it's time for qualifying, so settle down and enjoy the action. This is the kind of track that eats rear tyres for breakfast, or so I'm told by more experienced drivers than myself.
Well, tyre management is key here, specifically the rears. It's all too easy to overheat and wear the rear tyres as they're punished out of the low-speed corners. Most teams won't be able to avoid some kind of issue here, especially the teams that are running less downforce.
We'll be right back.
any particular car adjustments you would like made in the pit stop. When I do so, a prompt will appear on the MFD showing how long you have to respond. To answer, hold the radio button to open the radio screen. This will display your available responses. You may either speak the command or select it manually from the radio screen. Zone. We need you to go out again.
How are you? I have some information on the race goals you should keep in mind.
Hello and welcome one and all to the shining streets of Singapore. Can you believe we've been coming here for nearly a decade now? It feels like only yesterday that Felipe Massa was dragging his fuel hose down the pit lane in that eventful opening race, and in a Grand Prix won from pole position more often than not, will we see a new victor crowned today? Situated just 88 miles north of the equator, this 3.5 mile circuit is hot, it's humid, and is an incredible test for the drivers as they try to fight their cars around the bumps and in between the barriers. 23 corners take us twice over the bay to complete a single lap of this unique racetrack. The view is spectacular, the heat is unbearable. The race should be incredible. Anthony Davidson is alongside me in the commentary box this evening. And big race this one, a real test of endurance. Sounds right up your alley. Wouldn't you just love to be down there on the grid right now?
You know what, Crofty? I'm pretty happy to be up here in my air conditioning, thank you, right now. I can't stress just how difficult these conditions can be, especially when you consider it's the longest race on the calendar in terms of time. It's also one of those races where you have to remember to keep drinking, or there's a real risk of dehydration, just like we saw with young Kevin Magnussen a couple of years ago, don't forget. We mentioned the bumps as well. Take a look at the onboards if you get a chance during this race. The movement in the suspension and the chassis is just incredible. And it's lots of hard work to wrestle the car around the lap here.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. Sebastian Vettel will start on pole. Fantastic qualifying from the multiple world champion, with Daniel Ricciardo slotting in alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Rosberg, Hamilton, Max Verstappen and Raikkonen, Bottas, Alonso, Massa and Jenson Button, a Renault, Perez, Nico Hülkenberg and Palmer, Kvyat, Sainz, Pascal Wehrlein and Rio Haryanto, Grosjean and Gutierrez, Marcus Ericsson and Felipe Nasser starts from the back of the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Slow. Thank you.
fantastic victory for the Silver Arrows. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
Well, the safety car completely changed the race, didn't it? It's hard to say exactly what would have happened without it, but there's no question that they came out of that situation in a good position.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race. Round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. It's a good result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. Moving on to the driver of the day then, Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
It's a difficult one, but I'll have to go for the Renault driver. They fought so hard and had incredible pace at times, so I don't think anyone else did a better job today.
On to the constructors then. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. Meanwhile, Toro Rosso's strong weekend allows them to continue their march up the table. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.